Hi, I'm Jennifer Dre. I'm a senior EPMA consultant at EPMA. In this video, I'm going to cover briefly about how Microsoft Projects estimates durations. Have you ever noticed that in project, when you're planning a project and you know the exact number of work hours that a specific task will take to get completed, that you enter it and in turn it estimates a specific duration for you? Now, when it does that, notice how it shows also a question mark right next to the estimated duration you see right here in the duration column. Well, this question mark is there because it's intended to notify the user that, you know, a duration has been estimated. And the way Microsoft Project typically estimates or calculates that is by following the relationship between the work duration and assignment units through the equation where duration is equivalent to work divided by the assignment units. Now, on this example right here, let's go ahead and see how this works. For example, we know that, you know, deploying a report usually takes 10 hours, so we are gonna assign that to the developer and add the specific number of hours we know it takes. We will also don't enter it, but you know, leave it by project's default, which is assignment units of 100%. By clicking OK, we see here that the duration has been calculated by project as 1.25 days. Now, if notice that if we were to reduce the assignment of this resource to 50%, say, because we know that by the time when this report is going to be deployed, the developer is already going to be committed 50% to another project, then we would be, you know, changing this. And notice how project will automatically increase that duration to 2.5 days. Why? Because precisely by following this equation, it'll be dividing the work hours or effort, which is 10, which we knew in advance. It'll be dividing it now by 4, which is 50%, instead of 8 hours a day when we had it at 100%. Even if we were to add our project summary task, you will see how it will total up the duration column, but still leave this question mark, you know, telling you that it's adding up just estimated durations to 14 days. So say that you were pretty much done with, you know, putting together a brief schedule for this short project and you wanted to present it to your supervisor, but don't feel right about showing this schedule with question marks on it. Well, there's two ways to go about removing these question marks that pretty much project, you know, puts on by default. One way you could do it is going task by double clicking on it and going and unchecking the estimated box, which is right next to the duration. As you can see here, you uncheck it and it goes away. But if you were to have, you know, a larger list of tasks, a larger project, if you will, you don't wish to go one by one, you could also go to File, then, you know, Options, Find Schedule, and right about the middle of the window under scheduling options for this project, find this second check mark on the right hand side saying show that scheduled tasks have estimated durations. That's what project, you know, does by default, is checking out this box. But in this case, you'll go about unchecking it, click OK, and you can see back on your project that all of those question marks are gone. Now, well, hope this was useful. If you're interested in more video tips like these, stay tuned to our website and our YouTube channel for more. And if you'd like to enhance even more your project portfolio management skills, Sign up for one of our EPMA Institute upcoming training classes. You can be sure to leave armed with plenty of useful tips and tricks that'll help you maximize the use of your Microsoft PPM tools. Thanks, and until next time.